Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade with the start of a new fairly short tutorial on JSON for GameMaker Studio 2. It's going to be done in three parts. This first part here, we're going to talk about what JSON is. Then we're going to talk about importing JSON files. And then we're going to talk about exporting JSON files. Before we talk about that, let's talk about why you would want to learn how to use the JSON format. One good application is saving and loading. A lot of people use it for this, but saving and loading can be generalized into importing and exporting. Things like game data, you can use it for modding or creating custom levels. And on top of this, it's really just a great programming skill in general that applies both in and outside of GameMaker. So what is JSON? JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation, and it is a standardized means of representing data. Because it's standardized, it means it works across programs and languages. So although it originated with JavaScript, it is actually not JavaScript. And many programming languages actually have means of integrating with JSON files. It is also, and this is very important for us, human readable and writable. So you don't need a program or anything like that to translate JSON files. You can open up a text editor like Notepad and simply write them yourselves and read them yourself. So this leads us to two important questions. The first question is, what type of data can be represented in a JSON file? And the second question is, how is that data represented? There are several officially supported forms of data in JSON. You have numbers, and numbers in JSON files operate very much the way they do in GameMaker. It's really just any number. Strings, booleans, arrays, objects, and null. One thing I want to stress at this point is that we are interacting with JSON completely separately from GameMaker. So we will talk in the next two tutorials about what these types of data become when they are put inside of GameMaker. But right now we're talking about what they mean inside of a JSON format. And we'll cover each individually in a moment. But before we do that, let's talk about how data is represented. I do have a link at the end of this video to the complete rules of how to represent JSON. But if you try to break them down, they're actually a little bit complicated. And this is one of those areas where I really think that just a few simple rules and then practice will get you a lot farther faster. So the first thing you know is that a JSON file is a list of key value pairs separated by commas and enclosed in open brackets, close brackets. And I have an asterisk here because this is actually a slight oversimplification. You can also have the top level of a JSON file be an array, but it's normally taught with the top level being an object. And in fact, GameMaker essentially requires this. And so we're just going to pretend for the moment that that is actually the case. Top level should always be open brackets, close brackets. Keys are enclosed in quotation marks and followed by a colon. Strings use quotation marks, numbers are numbers. Booleans are written as true or false in all lowercase. Arrays use the square brackets and objects use the squiggly brackets. There'll be a link to the rules below, but they look a little bit like this. And why this is certainly useful if you want to get into the fine details of it, just practicing with the format is pretty straightforward. So here's a JSON example. Note that we have our starting and closing brackets. Then we have our key value pairs, where our keys are always enclosed in quotation mark. So we have name, John Smith. We have age, 25. Is alive, a Boolean value, true. We have address, colon, and then we have open brackets, close brackets. This is an object. Where inside of this object, we have keys and values as well. Two strings and a number. We have children, which is an array. And then we have spouse, which is the null value. So if you're like me, the first time you see this, it probably looks a little bit weird. You'd probably make a couple different mistakes. However, it really is very straightforward. And with a little bit of practice, you can write them quite easily. It'll become second nature, in fact. There's a couple good ways to follow along here. Opening a text editor, such as Notepad, I would write and save several JSON text files. I've already done this. You can also go to something like the JSON Editor Online and create some additional JSON files there. The nice thing about working with the JSON Editor Online is it will show you if you're making any mistakes. In the next tutorial, we'll work on importing these files into GameMaker Studio 2. So if I just load up Notepad here, I can create a JSON file very simply. Create the open brackets, close brackets, make a key, save some value to it. If it's not the final value, you add a comma, then you can add some more. And objects can be deeply nested. So this would be a very simple JSON in a text editor. You can also come over to the JSON editor online, where you have the nice ability to both write it over here, or you can actually create them over here. And this may be more interesting to actually do for a bit, just to see how it works. You can just add some things in at random. And then you can copy it over here and it will automatically format it for you as well. And this can be another good way to practice writing JSON files. In summary, JSON is a standardized way of representing data that humans can easily read and write. It can communicate across programs and languages. You can use it to represent numbers, strings, booleans, arrays, objects, and the value null. These resources will be below. There's the official website for JSON that has the hyper-specific rules for writing it diagrammed out, as well as the JSON Wikipedia article, which I think is a useful overview, and then a link to the free online JSON editor I was just using. We'll be back in the next tutorial to import JSON files into GameMaker Studio 2. All right, that's it. Thanks for watching.